What am I doing? What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Justin, and today we're listening to Kansas, this time with their song What's On My Mind, off of their album Left Overture, which was released in 1976. I barely pulled it up. I'm not saying that I'm going to listen to the whole album, but I'm probably going to work my way through the whole album. Hopefully you guys are enjoying it. I know that sometimes it takes me a while to get through albums to get to certain songs. There's probably hundreds and thousands of songs that come in by request and through the comments, and I'm sorry if I can't get to them all. I try to get to just whatever I can. There's no system, but I try. I hope that you guys are having a fantastic day. You can join me down in the comments if you want. You can join me down on Twitter, or over on Twitter, if you'd like. But otherwise, for now, let's just do it. This is What's On My Mind by Kansas. Electric. That little bit of ending section, that was surprising. I like that. It's a nice little pickup at the end. To me, the standout on this track is really the guitars. The guitar, Kerry Livgren, I didn't mean to mispronounce that. Kerry Livgren does a great job with the guitar, the leading throughout the whole thing, the riffing, especially some of the way that the solos and the leads would just soar out of there like a caged bird, no longer caged. It was just fantastic. I like that. The track was nicely high energy. The vocals by Steve Walsh, who's also doing the organ work. I really enjoyed that. I like how the verses are like vocals, bass, and organ. That's what I kind of hear, and that's what I kind of feel. And then in the choruses and in the pre-choruses, that's where it really picks up, especially with the guitar, and that's where the energy really kicks up. And it has this nice back and forth dynamic between the soft and the heavier. I like the ending of the chorus too, when he says, he's only saying what's on his mind. Letting the end notes of the chorus fly out a little bit, letting the guitar sweep in, kind of changing the direction of the energy. Whereas the vocals are now kind of going down, the guitar is rising up. And then it goes back into this other dynamic, it switches as it moves back into the verses. This break. This sounds good. The way that the bass comes in with that really strong groove, I like that a lot. And then right here, vocals and bass and a little bit on the keys. Yeah. This felt like a more single kind of song from Kansas. This felt like something that could easily be played on the radio. This felt like, not that they were pressured to make a single to play on the radio, but this would be it. This is perfect. Coming home from work, 5, 6 o'clock or whatever, and this is what you need to get you through the day. This is what you need as you're getting out of work. And you're driving home, you're stuck in traffic, you just want to get home, this is providing you that energy that you need. Well, you told me that I was just not the one, and you left me standing out in the cold. It's been a long time, and I'm so much better now that I'm looking back and seeing it all. And for the first time, there's no pain in my life. It's been a long, hard road that I've gone. We had a good thing, and it made me a man, and I know. And then in the next verse, he says, well, I found you, or maybe I found myself, and I think we knew it all the time. We fit together just like a lock and a key. And we open up each other's minds. So it kind of feels like maybe he's confessing maybe his love for someone. Like he's felt it the whole time that they've been perhaps friends. Like he was friend-zoned. But then like at a certain point, like they both just knew that they were meant for each other romantically. Or if I go back and actually read the lyrics, the first line says, you told me that I was just not the one. So he was rejected. Maybe that's where I should be looking at. And he was left standing in the cold. But then looking back on that from the future, he's saying, you know, maybe that was for the best. You came from nowhere and you just jumped in my life, and I know it never will be the same. You made me love you, now I'm home once again. No, I never want to leave you, no more. Cause I returned to the better half of myself, and there is nowhere else that I'd rather be. You fill in empty, you fixed up my broken heart. So maybe at one point he approached this person romantically like, hey, you want to be together? And they're like, nah. And then they were sad, they were broken, they had a broken heart, right. Maybe years, I would assume, passed. At some point, they reconnected in the future, and it was a better time for both of them to be together. And that's why he was grateful that, like, you know, maybe he was grateful for the rejection, because the time allowed him to grow as a person, allowed him to mature, and now he's like, you know, I'm a better person now. I think we're a little bit more of a better fit right now. Things would be gravy. And then he's saying at the end, I'm only saying what's on my mind. I'm only saying what's on my mind. And he's talking about just telling this person his feelings. So I think we're actually left on a little bit of a cliffhanger. I don't know if the person is reciprocating those feelings or not. And as far as I can tell looking into the lyrics, I don't see an answer, at least on this track. Of course, I want to know what you guys thought of the song. You can join me on Twitter. You can join me in the comments down below. I hope that you guys are having a wonderful day. I hope that whatever is on your mind is a good thing, is a positive thing. Have a fantastic day, guys, and I will talk to you tomorrow. Bye.